गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ शारदा देवरे, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी, अमरावती, महाराष्ट्र. टुडे वी विल लर्न टॉपिक हर्बल फॉर्मुलेशंस. इन हर्बल इंडस्ट्री देर आर डिफरेंट डोसेज फॉर्म्स यूज टू एडमिनिस्टर द हर्बल ड्रग्स. फ्यू ऑफ देम आर एडमिनिस्टर्ड थ्रू द ओरल, टॉपिकल और पैरेंटल रूट. फ्यू ऑफ देम फॉर ऑप्थेल्मिक यूज. फ्यू ऑफ देम कैन बी इनहेल्ड एंड फ्यू ऑफ देम आर सपोजिटरी. Syrup is very simple and most preferred herbal formulation in herbal industry. It is defined as a sweet viscous concentrated aqueous solution of sugar, and that is a sucrose. Other sugars are dextrose, sorbitol. Sucrose is partially hydrolyzed into reducing sugars, levulose and dextrose. This helps in retarding the oxidation. There are different types of the syrups. Simple syrup, which contains the sugar and the water mixture. Medicated syrup is added with the medicaments or therapeutic agents. Flavoring or flavor syrups are added with the flavoring agents. Artificial syrup contains the artificial sweetener or artificial sugar, and this is very good for the diabetic patients. Dry syrup is a powder mixture in a dry form, and this is very good for the pediatric use. What is the advantage of syrup? Syrup is very good for masking the disagreeable tasting drugs like nauseous, saline or bitter drugs. High viscosity and mouth feel helps in masking this disagreeable tasting by blocking the taste buds. Good demulcent and soothing efficacy of the syrup dosage form makes it a most suitable or most preferred formulation for cough preparations. What are the ingredients of the syrup? Syrup contains sugar, antimicrobial agents or preservatives, flavorants, colorants, with or without the medicament. Syrup IP is a 66.7% wet by sweat solution of sucrose, where syrup USP is 64.74% of wet by wet solution of the sucrose. There is a slight difference between the percentage of the sucrose. When the concentration of the sucrose is low, then preservatives need to be added like parabens, benzoic acid, glycerin. Few of the syrup also contains alcohol as a preservative or alcohol as one of the ingredient. Syrups can be prepared by the four methods. First method is a hot process for the substance, which are thermolabile or thermostable or thermo resistance. In this method, sucrose and water are boiled together, then strained, and if required, the volume is made up with the boiled purified water. Examples of the syrups made by this process are syrup IP, acacia syrup NF, that is national formulary, coca syrup NF, and tolu syrup IP. Second method is a percolation, which is also called as a cold process or syrup USP preparation method. In this method, sucrose is packed in a percolator and purified water is allowed slowly to pass through the sucrose. Third method is addition of a medicating or flavoring liquid to the syrup. In this method, fluid extracts, tinctures or other liquids are to be added to the syrup. In this method, alcohol is also most preferred preservative. Fourth and last method of preparation of a syrup is agitation without heat, and which is very good for the thermolabile or thermosensitive constituents. In this method, sucrose and other ingredients, if prescribed in a formula, and purified water are added in a bottle, and bottle is shaked through manual or mechanical agitators so that uniform syrup formulation is formed. Syrup should be stored at a temperature not exceeding 25 degrees Celsius. It should be stored in a well-dried, completely filled and carefully stoppered bottles in a cool, dark place. It should never be freezed because it can cause the precipitation of the sucrose or sugar. Syrup should be evaluated for the appearance, color, odor, taste, pH, weight per ml, that is a density, viscosity, and it should be studied for the stability studies for determination of shelf life. Next herbal formulation is a mixture. Mixture is again the liquid preparation like the syrup. It is also the very simple type of the formulation, and again it is also the most preferred type of the formulation in herbal industry. A mixture is a liquid preparation meant for oral administration in which medicament or medicaments are dissolved, suspended or dispersed in a suitable vehicle. Mixture is term also useful for the suspension. In herbal industry, polyherbal mixtures are very commonly available in a market. Advantage of a mixture: it is very easy to administer. It is very suitable for insoluble and immiscible drugs. It is found to be give the more viability of the herbal drugs compared to the solid dosage forms like the tablet capsules. What are the disadvantages? The less stable, expensive, there are more incompatibilities. These are the few disadvantages of the mixture formulation. What are the types of the mixture? Obvious, simple mixture containing soluble substances where herbal drug and the vehicle. Second type, it is a mixture containing diffusible solids, means solids do not dissolve in water, but on shaking that can be mixed. Third type, it is a mixture containing indiffusible solids. In this type of the mixture, thickening agents like the gum acacia tragacanth or compound tragacanth need to be added so that indivisible solid can form the uniform mixture. Fourth type, it is a mixture containing precipitate forming liquids. In this mixture also, protective colloid is dispersed in the vehicle before the tincture is or before the herbal drug is added. Fifth and last type of the mixture is mixture containing colloidal particles. In this mixture, herbal drug is added with alkali like the NaOH, and then it is mixed by the hydration to form the colloidal mixture. Examples of the mixture are simple mixture containing soluble substance, that is orange syrup, mixture containing diffusible solid, that is a rhubarb powder, mixture containing indiffusible solids, that is aromatic chalk powder, mixture containing precipitate forming liquids, that is a mere tincture or tolu tinctures, mixture containing slightly soluble liquid, that is a milk of magnesium. Mixture should be always stored in a plain glass bottles with a uniform internal diameter. It should have the suitable removable cork to prevent the spilling of the mixture. Mixture should be evaluated for the physical appearance, that is color, odor, taste, pH, weight per ml, viscosity and stability study. Next dosage form or a herbal formulation, it is a tablet. Mixture and syrup are liquid formulations, while tablet, it is a solid dosage form. Tablet is defined as the solid unit dosage form containing a medicament or mixture of a medicament and excipients like diluents, binders, lubricants, disintegrants, wetting agents, compressed or molded into the solid cylindrical shape having either flat or convex surface. There are different types of the tablet: monoherbal or polyherbal tablets, compressed tablets, sugar-coated tablets, film-coated tablets, enteric-coated tablets, effervescent tablets, chewable tablets, dispersible, sustained-release, multilayer, sublingual, buccal tablets, implant tablets, hypodermic tablets, vaginal tablets, etc. Out of these, very few types of the tablets are useful for the herbal drug administration. There are three methods of preparation of the tablets. First is a weight granulation method, which is oldest and most widely used method, involving steps weighing of the ingredients, mixing, granulation, screening the granules, drying screening, lubrication, and finally compression through the tablet punching machine. Second method of preparation of the tablet is a dry granulation method, which is also called as slugging, double compression or recompression method. It is very good for the thermolabile or moisture sensitive ingredients. The steps involved in granulation method are weighing of the ingredients, slugging, dry screening, lubrication and compression through the tablet punching machine. Third and last method, it is a direct compression. It is very good for the crystalline drugs. Simple absence of a granulation step, avoidance of the moisture and drying step, minimal material handling, rapidity of the total process and optimal possible viability of the drugs from the resulting tablet. It is the beauty of this particular method of preparation of the tablet. Tablet should be evaluated for the physical nature, that is the shape, size, weight, color, and if it is imprinted, then for the imprinting. Then content of the active ingredient, that is through the official assay. Uniformity for the content, friability, that is very good for knowing the wear and tear during handling and shipping of the tablets, hardness, disintegration and dissolution tests. Dear students, we have studied three traditional dosage forms, syrup, mixture and tablet, and all these three dosage forms are most preferred dosage form, most preferred type of the formulations in herbal drug industry. But there are few novel drug delivery systems are also, and nowadays there is a lot of researchers are working on forming the novel drug delivery system for herbal drugs. There are different types of the novel drug delivery system: vesicular carriers, that is a liposomes, neosomes, ethosomes, transposomes, emulsosomes, phytosomes, etc. Micellar carriers like the polymeric micelle, mixed micelles, particulate carriers like the solid lipid nanoparticles, nanostructured lipid carriers, polymeric nanoparticles, or emulsified carriers, that is a microemulsion, nanoemulsion, lipid emulsions, etc. What are the drawbacks of conventional dosage form, or why there is a need of doing a research on novel drug delivery system? The major drawback of conventional dosage form like syrup, mixture or tablet, it is a poor patient compliance and missing the dose of the drug. Fluctuation in drug concentration lead to the under medication or over medication of the over medication, and thus it can cause the side effects. What are the advantages of a novel drug delivery system? As most of the novel drug delivery systems are of a reduced particle size, and there is an increase in the solubility, enhancement in the viability, protection from the toxicity, enhancement in the pharmacological activity, as well as enhancement in the stability. Phytosome, it is the formulation that is similar like the liposome, or which is having a lipid carrier system. But there is a difference between the phytosome and liposome. In phytosome, the phosphatidylcholine and the plant components or the herbal drug actually form the molecular complex and involves the chemical bonds. While liposomes, there are no chemical bond is formed between the phosphatidylcholine and the drug molecule. Preparation method for the phytosome is that one mole of a phospholipid, that is a natural or synthetic, such as the phosphatidylcholine, phosphatidyl ethanolamine or phosphatidyl serine, with one mole of phytocomponent or phytochemical either alone or in the natural mixture in a protic solvent such as dioxone or acidone, from which complex can be isolated by precipitation or lyophilization or by spray drying method. Common ratio range between these two moieties is 0.5 as to 2 moles, or the most preferable ratio is 1 mole of the phospholipid and 1 mole of the phytochemical. Phytosomes should be evaluated for rheological properties like viscosity. It should be evaluated for zeta potential, surface charge, polydispersity, and the most important, particle size. Then it should be evaluated for drug entrapment efficiency and drug release. Thank you, students. Hope you have understood about the traditional dosage form as well as the novel dosage form like the phytosome. Thank you.